at the time, we were drinking water from buckets. Yes. You know, somebody selling ice water has this nicely shine. The better the shine, the better probably it is, you know, instead of looking at the quality. And you can imagine the health problems it posed to consumers. One cup can be used by 1,000 people. And then we didn't have any cure for, BP, yeah. You know, TB. So you can imagine the number of people who were infected by the TB disease, and talk about flu, talk about some of these communicable diseases. Mm. So for me, I had to go into it because I was looking for an alternative. I was concerned as an individual, you know, and in doing so, a business emerged. Seeing people drinking from cars, can't we have, since they want it, that means that they want it. It's not a matter of banning it, but it's a matter of finding an alternative which is more suitable, reducing the health risks in that sector. And that's what I decided to do. So, I was working with Mobil Oil Ghana Limited. Then we went to Nigeria for training. And when we went there, that's where I saw that,
Working with Mobil
Oil Ghana Limited.
Oh, those days, okay.
Exactly. And then I saw that, they package water in sachet. As soon as I came down, went straight to the poly product. I said, can you do this for me? And they could.
But it was very smart.
Yeah, exactly, to penetrate the market. So it was more problem-based. It was born out of a problem that I saw. So in attempting to solve that problem, a business emerged, and today everybody is enjoying from the fruits of, to say, my ideas, right? Smart people, dare to believe it. Smart people, always believe it. Smart people, smart people, smart people, always make a change.
So you resigned as soon as you saw the sachet water in Nigeria?
I didn't resign. I was asked to resign because of the water.
You were asked to?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Because then I was working there, and then my wife was running this water with myself along on the sidelines. And then somebody reported, listen, the guy is working with you and he's also doing another business.
But does it matter?
Well,
once
that's
you
what
don't...
he said. And then... you know, people have to, you know, in Ghanaian business, so much of politics, I wouldn't want to go there. But the good thing is that I left.
But the thing is that when one door shuts
another
opens.
That is what we don't see. Of course, initially it was a bit difficult, but my leg was on something. I knew what it is. Thank God I did it still, and they kicked me out. But then it was for a good cause.
Yeah.
And the very reason why I was made to resign is what has seen me where I am today.
But when you were going to resign, what was going through your mind? Because at that time you hadn't set up properly, the income wasn't that
obviously good. It wasn't easy. Can you imagine? I mean, what my wife could tell you, you know, my wife is a very sensitive woman, right? To break the news to her that, listen, I've been kicked out of business. Kicked out
because of one small pill.
So I came, Sally. So that day I came, I woke up in the morning, and to break the news, can you imagine? This poor woman, my husband is up today, he's dressed up, he has to go to work. I actually woke up, took my bath, dressed up, put on my tie. Auntie going, so I'll be going, you wait. I went to the washroom, came back, I sat down, and but you leave early. By 7, you should be gone. Now it's about 8 o'clock, you are still here. And I'll be there, she'll shout, aren't you going? I said, I'll be going. So you can imagine what was going on in my mind. It was very difficult. It wasn't easy at all. It wasn't easy. But eventually, I had to let the cat out. And then eventually, around 10 o'clock, and she started getting worried. And I said, listen, I must tell her what is happening. So I started, please come sit by me. She said, the reality is that I've been booted out. I took off my tie, and her face was... You know, so that was it. But for me, bad thing, but opportunities out there was what I had to, you know. And what I was going to be in future, so much depended on what I had imbibed when I was working with them.
Yeah.
And that for me was the key. I mean, I still cherish that company. The training I received, you know, the training. I told you from the beginning that whatever you lay your hands on, depends on the way you want to handle the level. Exactly. And I believe that mobile water is what it is today because of the strides I made in that company. The training I had there brought it to bear on this very company. I started off not producing water, not thinking that I'm producing sachet water or ice water. No, I started off with the same, work ethics that existed with my company, my work schedule. They will give you a target to, you are given a target to achieve. And that for me, that's what I set out to do. No matter how small the thing was, I said, listen, over there, where I worked, they gave you a target. You are supposed to produce this or sell this within this time. So I sat down myself and drew these plans myself. Okay, this year I'm going to do this. Next year I drew up a plan, or how do you call it, a 5-year growth plan. Trust me. And the thing worked. I was growing at an exponential rate, about 200% per annum. And I was recording everything. One time I forgot, I don't know why I left that thing. After 5 years or 6 years or so, my workers were going through my records. And then they saw a plan I had drawn. Then, that was in 1999 or so, and how the company was going to be in 2005, a roadmap. And precisely, absolutely, brought it there, and I was so excited. I looked at it. Everything I said in that plan had come to pass. And I grew faster than that. So that was the thing. I mean, getting the training. People enter into job with a view to make a lot of money, wanting to become there. Of course, if you enter a job, the ultimate goal is to become the CEO of that company. Exactly. Those who are there, they can get there. That's okay. But then, of course, mind you, you can only have one CEO.
I was just going to say that.
You can only have maximum 5 members. But you enter, you have about 200 or so. I guess you can't force there to be there. You must be what you are. I was asked to leave, but I would have left anyway because when I was going into that job, I went there with a view to becoming an entrepreneur, businessman on my own, trust me. So I wanted somewhere to get the training, an environment where I can be trained on how to do business. I had a bank in mind. I had a very good company. I wasn't going to settle for any company at all. But I wanted the training because I knew what I wanted to do. Mind you, before this time, if you ask my siblings and my mom, I had tried a lot of businesses. I like experiments, One time I was into poultry farming, one time I baked cake. So I've done a lot of things with good successes.
You baked cake?
Yeah, sure. Whoa. Yeah, I did. If you give me a bowl right now, not cook, but I can give you very good cake. Trust me, I'm the best. I prepare the best cake. Trust me.
Hold it. He prepares the best cake. If you want to have a wedding, come, he'll prepare cake for you.
But now it will be very, very expensive because a cake prepared by the CEO.
Wow.
Just like asking the president.
Extra price.
Yeah, extra price. But all jokes aside, I can prepare very good cake.
So you've
for
done
you.
All of
I've
that.
I've done all of that.
This is where I start to feel very emotional. You had done what? Cake.
Cake, baking, poultry. Mm-hmm. Farming, youth local. I've tried all businesses, right?
And what happened to them?
For me,
did not go well.
No, it didn't go well. Before schooling, this is something I wanted to add. You can't cage me, right? I don't like being caged. Even when I was working with mobile.
You are not a bird to be caged.
No, I'm not a bird to be caged. Even when I was working with mobile, right? You see, wherever I go, I earn a name.
Tell
from
me,
school.
You were working with mobile,
yes.
And your water is mobile water. What is that?
It's one of the questions that always comes up. We say mobile
and
mobile. Yes. Does it have any bearing? Yes and no.
Why?
No, in the sense that is then I was in the field. I mean, we like area manager or territory rep. So we traveled a lot, and then there was nothing like water to drink. We didn't have this bottle of water where you can carry along. So imagine you traveling to a place like Mkwanta. Water to drink was an issue, and so you can't help when you're traveling, you have to buy soft drinks in your booth, and that's what you actually quaffed in, So for me, I thought of when I was going to name the brand, I was in a situation where I was forced to buy soft drinks, not because I wanted it, but I wanted something very close substitute to water, and every time pumping this sugar into your system. So then when I had to name the brand, I had to pick a name, like something to carry along.
So, mobile.
Something
okay.
I can carry along.
Okay.
Then, that was the time mobile phones had come in. And then you had this big phone like Plantain. I think that time it was only Rollins who had one.
The mobiles.
Yeah, the mobile, the big phone. Yes. You can have a phone as big as this.
Oh, it was bigger than
this. I think
this.
That time it was only the president. He was in the 1990-something, you know. Yes. So,
and you need a carrier bag.
Yeah,
to
exactly.
Put
so
in.
You can see, I can remember very well, John Rawlings, and he was the president of the time. You see him in meetings holding the phone.
Yes, very big.
Very big phone like that, you know. But people dare to
be different. Still talking to Mr. Magnus Nunoo, the MD of Mobile Water. Hey, we have a very interesting magazine. It's also called Smart People. If you have business and you want to grow it, you have to come and advertise in it. Well, we give it out for free, but you have to pay something small for your advert. And I tell you, it is working for people, so try it. Well, Mr. Nunoo, how did you start when you broke the news to her? Because then you had started on a very small scale.
Yeah, exactly. So now, when I broke the news to her, mind you, I was already producing the water on a very small scale. So
yeah.
Now I had time.
I wish you could go there take pictures, I remember.
what I lost was a job. What I gained was time.
Yeah. To put in more effort.
Absolutely. You see, then I could have been. Because I started off, because I was working somewhere, other companies came and they were doing it big time. And I was just doing the thing small, and my wife had just given birth, which a baby boy, the boy you just saw, right? So we couldn't do it that big. So when I came, I said, fine, then let me give my time to this. And do it well. So I got time and utilized it very well with all the business practices, good business management practices I had imbibed from mobile. And the results kept coming. Of course, for a company that was growing at an average rate of 100% per annum, I wasn't just doing business. I mean, I was tracking the growth rate. I could tell you what I was doing, how the thing was going and everything. And I was growing at an average rate of about 100% for about 8 years. You know, then I started having this flat top something. It's usually, I mean, you draw a normal distribution curve.
Yeah.
It steeps up and then
and
gradually,
down.
exactly. So we picked up and then the growth rates, you know, stagnated. And now we have a lot of people coming in. But that's good. It makes you a better person and cool. But for me, like I said, what I lost was a job. What I gained was time.
Mr. Nunoo, so I am interested in the challenges you have to go through to get your company to where it is today, because you won so many awards internationally, locally, and I mean.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes. So tell me, because that is where my passion is. We need to dwell on that so people can learn from you who have made it already.
No, you see, it was like one thing that comes to mind anytime anybody is into business is capital. Capital becomes the lifeblood of the business. You need money to get a business going, you know. My mind always goes back to what we studied in commerce or business then, factors of production, land, labor, capital, entrepreneur. Entrepreneur, I'm there as the entrepreneur. That's it. The other factors are land, then labor, and then the capital to buy the equipment. Yeah. You know, so I had to use some of these things I learned. Capital, what do I need money for? It's not, you see, people go chasing the money, not really knowing what they want to use the money for. And if you don't know what you're going to use the money for, the bank gives you a loan and you use it to buy 4x4 and ride in. I mean, no aim, no goal. So, but then land, labor, capital, mind you, I need money. You don't go saying that I need money. The question is, if you need money, what for? That's the first one. Number two, how much do you need? And number three, do you really need that money? These are the things. If you can answer these questions, then you can go in for the money. What for? I need to buy a machinery. Is that the best way? If I want to buy an equipment to work with, you first must depend on your negotiating skills. Sometimes you don't really need the money to do that. If somebody can sell the equipment to you on credit, and to be able to buy something on credit, you must be credible.
Yeah.
Many times people really struggle to get funds because, you know, they are not trustworthy. Somebody has entrusted you with, let's say, okay, let me supply you this on credit. You have to prove yourself. You need to pay back that money. If you know you are not worth it, so don't go there. What is going to carry you to the next day for another bank to give you another money? You must be that person who is credible. To be credible means that, listen, I take this money and I paid. If you can't pay, go back, sit down with them, renegotiate and pay, and keep paying and keep that credibility, because that for me is your capital, you know, and that is an alternative to borrowing money from the bank. Now, labor. Labor is always 1 month free, 1 month on credit. If I employ you, I don't need to pay you. You need to work for me for 1 month.
Exactly.
So you need to go into some of these details and then define what you need and go exactly for what you need. If you don't need it, if you have money, for example, you pick up money to start business, and then you use the money all the summer. He says, please go back quickly and pay back, because there's no idle funds out there. Any money you keep, which is idle, you are paying interest on it.
Yes.
So people don't do this, and they land into trouble, you know, and well, the banks are not there. So many times,
before you continue, somebody will also say that I have the ideas, but I don't have what it takes to go for a loan to start a business. So that is always the excuse. I have this wonderful, marvelous ideas, but I don't have the fund. Mm-hmm. I've been to the bank, they wouldn't listen to me because I'm a fresher and all of that. You understand? Because the banks will ask for a collateral. If I'm just from out of school and I want to set up a business, I don't have a collateral. Otherwise, I would have sold my house to do a business, or just bring it straight to your table that this is what I have to take a loan. You know, and that's, for me, it's also, I don't know.
It's just like, all companies or establishments coming to say that, you know, for me to employ you, you need work experience.
Yes.
But if nobody employs you, how do you get a
work experience?
That's absolutely the same. Is the same thing here we're talking about. Many times we have ideas, we have lofty ideas, but mind you, the ideas are not tested. The fact that I want to sell aeroplane doesn't mean it's good. You know, I can design something and I have this thing in mind I want to do. It doesn't mean we must test the market. Is there market for it? That is why there's a need for you to, sample opinions of what you want to do. Draw up the cash flows, realistic cash flows. Cash flows means that, listen, I want to do this business. These are the ideas I want. How much money do I need? Which are the people I want to work with and whatnot? What is available market potential? Sit down yourself, go into your Excel or what have you, and then come out with a cash flow, realistic cash flows.
If I'm an account student, okay, I know the accounting aspect, cash flow and everything will come in, but the management side, I need people to help me work at it. But if I don't get the fund, the capital to start with, because how many people?
A lot of people have come to me, like as I was speaking, somebody has come to me, and the person says, okay, you know what? Can you help me? I say, well, can I help you? What do you want to do? I need money. For what? I want to go buy maize from the hinterland and come and sell. That's a very good idea. Mm. Why? Because everybody eats maize.
Exactly.
You either eat banku or you eat cake. That's a very good business idea. Have you done your cash flow? Say, I've done it. How much money do I need? 15,000 Ghana cedis. Okay, 15,000 Ghana cedis. That's lovely. Now, then I started going into details. Okay, 15,000 Ghana cedis. How much does it cost? He said, it costs 8,000 Ghana cedis. How much are you going to sell it? I'm going to sell it. What is it? It was going to make about 6,000. So what is the potential? How much? What is the transport element they give me? Then how are you going to sell it? I'm going to sell it on credits. You see, so for me, you see, the person has a very laudable idea, but you see, starting on a very wrong route. You're going to give your money, you go to the bank, collect money from the people, go and give it to these women on the market. I'm not saying some of them are not credible. You're going to start a business, you know how the thing goes. And then you pump this money out there and sell the thing on credit. This, for me, credit is good. For me to give you credit, then I'll look at my cost build up again and try to reduce the products for you to give me cash. A bird in hand is worth so many birds in the bush. That is it. So the idea good, profitability wasn't so bad. Well, I had to discount it by certain factors. It could still make a few Ghana cedis per month or per day. That was good. But is it approach?
Wasn't right.
You're definitely going to land in a ditch. First time business, this, of course, you can use it, but you are saying that you're going to get 100% and get your money back. These are the issues. And that's where I'll talk about training.
So these are the issues the banks look at.
These are the issues. You see, you need to. People come out from the university with very good ideas. You know, I came out from the university, I had practiced doing business on my own, but I still wanted to work in an environment to see the other challenges that go with getting business up there. You know, so I need to come under somebody. Push me, hit me here, know all the challenges, use your place. Then when I come out, I'll be a better person. Look at where you are. You can get yourself employed. I always tell you, if you want to be a business, try and get yourself. Don't come straight from the university.
Yes.
It's possible to do that, but don't, many times, just get yourself, you're young, maybe about 22 years, 25 years, you're out from the university. You know what, spend five years. Get yourself employed. Work under an environment
and
with
get
all
trained.
Get trained. That's where you get the training. Don't go in with a view to becoming the CEO. Go in with a view to
learn.
Learn. learning the tricks or what it takes. There's a way out there which you don't know. These big companies and multinationals, they have it. That's why they're growing. You must learn that secret. The big companies, I don't want to mention them to promote anybody. You know them. You know, if you put in your CV to get that job, you know how it is. But struggle with your negotiation skills. You have to get into that place. Mm. Once you get there, don't dream of becoming the CEO. But try and buy all the training that you need to. They give you target, do it. All the hardship, go through it. After that, come out and start your own business. Give yourself 10 years and compare.
So then now, you had been through the fire.
You've been through the mill. You've been through the fire. There's a way out there. I always say there's a way out there. The same business that is done at Makola is what is done at UT Bank.
Exactly.
Same. But the difference is the management. The package. The management style.
Yes.
Same thing. What is it? You're selling tomatoes. You need money to buy it. That's capital. And you are there, tomatoes, you know, they carry it, tomato. It's a way of advertising.
Yeah.
And then UT Bank goes on air and it says,
48 hours.
It's still an advert.
Exactly.
It's the same thing. Aside from getting a training, get a mentor. You can be studying somebody, the person doesn't know you are studying him.
Oh, yes.
Just quietly, what the way the person is doing, aspire to be there.
It's true.
You see, let the skies be the starting point. Mm. Don't stop at the skies. Mm. After you got into the skies, I mean, the room is endless.
Yeah.
And try going out there. So for me, it's a whole package. Sit down, money. Listen, the banks are there. Trust me. What is the business of a bank?
To help people.
To help people. The guy is there. Listen, he doesn't produce water. He doesn't produce ice cream. He's there. Money. I want to give it out to somebody who can convince me that when I give the money to him, he's going to pay me back. The problem with Ghanaians, I told you, it is. I went somewhere to one of these very, very, and then I asked for the price of a car. You know, if I go to a place, I'm asking, it doesn't mean I'm going to buy it. Sometimes you go there, they chase you out. I just want to satisfy my listing. And then they say, oh, this bank manager has come for it. He says he's going to collect money from the bank to come and buy it. And I checked the price of the car. They said $120,000. And then he said, what? Who's going to buy it? So one of the managers working with the bank, he's trying to get a loan. Who are you going to please? You use $120,000 when you come to buy a car and you are trying to, you know, this tells
you. So it's all about management.
It's all about management and what you are out there. Some people want to buy a car.
People buy a car. I'm not saying that you care.
If you have actually toiled, if I walk into a shop and I want to buy a car.
You have worked for it.
I know I have worked for it, not with even loan. Yeah. You understand what I'm saying? But then for you to be a salary worker, and then they say the person is raising. You can imagine the problem the person is trying to create for himself. Smart people dare to be different.